Hey everyone, so we're continuing our ear training, okay? Now, how have you been going so far? How did you go on the test? Comment below and let me know, because if this is getting too hard or if this is getting too easy, it's your comments below that will shape the next ear training videos, okay? But today, we're gonna dive into the world of major thirds. Now, it's so very important that you understand what a major third is, okay? So what a major third is boom, we've got a C major scale there, okay? All the scale degrees, 1 to 8, yeah? Okay, all we want is 1, 3, 5. It's those three numbers there, or those three intervals, that make a C major chord. Or if you just take 1, 3, 5 and apply it to any other note, you get any other major chord. So it's very, very important. The third note is extremely important because it's the third note or the third degree that tells you whether it's a major chord or a minor chord. And that's all you change. So if you've got a D major chord, if you flatten the third degree, which is F sharp, if you take it down a semitone or a fret from the second fret to the first fret on the high E string, you get D minor. So that one note has a big, big change on chords, okay? But we are looking at intervals today. So we're looking at the minor third and of course the major third as well, and I'll give you 10 different examples. You will be able to see my guitar, so please, if you do want to train your ears, okay, maybe shift the window to a side so you can still hear it but not see it, or scroll down to the comments below. Minor thirds and major thirds, okay? So I'm gonna play using C, third fret of the fifth string, or third fret on the A string, with your first finger, that's our C note there, that's gonna be our root note, okay, our C. We're going to do ascending or intervals going up, okay? And all you do is you stretch out your pinky till you can hit it on the sixth fret of that fifth string or the A string. So that's a minor third. So root note or number one. And our minor third or flattened third. Okay. So the way I remember the minor third interval, and I reckon it'll work for you as well, is to think of that starting riff that so many guitarists learn because it's so awesome, yeah? Google it if you haven't heard of it before. Deep Purple, and the song is Smoke on the Water. So now I'm just gonna apply it to that C note that we have been looking at. The middle C note, okay? So that's the minor third. Does it sound different to Smoke on the Water? I bet it does, but listen to the interval. The same interval. You've got the first note, and then on Smoke on the Water, the first interval there is the minor third. Yeah, it's all in there, okay? Great, so now we're gonna move on to the major third interval. Now, a major third is what makes a major chord sound like a happy major chord. It's that third degree. So how you play that, I reckon the easiest way is to use your second finger, if you're playing on the fifth, sixth, or fourth string, use your second finger, okay? And then your first finger, a string below on a fret behind. So in this example, my second finger is on the third fret of the fifth string, or the A string. And my first finger is a fret behind and a string below onto the second fret of that fourth string, or the D string. It's best to remember this song, and it works for me, but by all means find out other intervals and other songs that work well for you, is the start of that song, Oh When the Saints Come Marching In, yeah? Again, if you haven't heard it, Google it, but Oh When the Saints, that first interval, Oh When, yeah? So that's how I would remember that particular interval. So, with minor thirds, the start of Smoke on the Water, yeah? You know the rest? Okay, so just the start. That's your minor third. And for the major third, Oh When the Saints Come Marching In. So when you hear it together, here's a major chord. That's with the major third. And here it is, the same chord, but with a minor third. Different sounding chord, isn't it? Yeah, big difference. So when you're looking at a chart, or when you're just learning chords, and you see major chord, all that it's implying is that the third is major. And when you see a minor chord, it's implying that the third degree is flattened. That's all that a major chord is, and that's all that a minor chord is, okay? When you're talking specifically of triads. By the end of the video, there's all those social networks, so feel free to contact me there and just let me know how you're going. Good luck, everyone. Let's get started. Well, that's it, guys. How did you go? Again, leave comments below and let me know how you went, okay? If it is a little bit too challenging, you just have to tell me and then we'll see how we go, okay? But well done for making it to the end. And as always, if you like what I do, click like. Every like helps me. And if you want to see more, click subscribe. Lots more ear training videos coming up. But just remember, with the minor third, okay? It's like the start of Smoke on the Water. You know how that sounds, yeah? And with the major third, it's the first interval of Oh When the Saints Go Marching In, yeah? And together, the minor third always sounds a little bit shaky because it's just an ugly interval there. And the major third just works out a little bit better. But that's what I think. What do you guys think? Comment below and let me know. See you again, guys. Bye.